G'day folks, Ben from Snowy's here today with the Evakool Down Under 75 litre dual zone Australian made fridge freezer. As I mentioned, this is an Australian made fridge signed by the maker here in Australia. It's got two zones, a reliable compressor, and it's made tough just for the Australian conditions. Now the fridge weighs about 30 kilos. It's made nice and heavy duty. Now measurements from side to side here, excluding the handles, we're looking at about 82.9 centimetres. 89.5 centimeters, including the handles here. Now you can remove those if you like. There are screws in the end. We'll show you a bit more on that shortly. Width-wise here, we've got about 50.4 centimeters and height-wise about 47.3, 47.4 centimeters from top to bottom there. If we have a bit of a look at the outside of the fridge, starting with the top, these are a polypropylene lid and this is all filled with refrigeration grade insulation inside here. So these are a flexible but tough lid. The side is a powder coated steel, which runs all the way around the outside here. And there's steel components and also rubber bumpers. So on the bottom here, we've got rubber bumpers around the side here. If we have a bit of a tour around, starting on this side here, we've got two really big fans here, which make a little bit of noise, but it makes them really efficient. It moves a lot of air out and away from the compressor. And in behind there is a Secop compressor. You can see that the badge here to show that it's a genuine Secop compressor, so good quality. Got the handle at the top here, which is a spring-loaded handle. And as I mentioned, you can see that there are screws in here, so you probably could remove that if you wanted, but otherwise they sit reasonably flush. They stick out a little bit, but they're not handles that stick all the way out. It does sit nice and flush, and you can use them as tie-down points as well. We'll come around to the back here before we go back around to the front. We can see we've got not much to see on the back. We have got another panel here for a bit of ventilation where the compressor sits. You've got the hinges at the top here, four hinges, because we've got two lids. And then these here are tie down points. So there's a little bar in there. So you can put a strap in there or a webbing strap and use that as a tie down point for the fridge. And moving around to the other end of the fridge here, another spring loaded handle, same as the other ends. And we've got an Anderson port here. So they've chosen just to use an Anderson port for power into the fridge. So however you plug something into this, whether it's 240 volt, 12 volt, 24 volt, goes in through this Anderson plug here. And then moving around to the front of the fridge, much like the back, except we've got these two nice heavy duty latches here for the lid. So can't go nothing can go wrong with those latches. They're nice and heavy duty. You've got those tie down points too on the front here. So just that little bar in the middle there so that you can put a webbing strap around there and tie it down. Another vent at the bottom here, and then you've got your control panel here, which we'll go into a little bit on shortly. I'll plug it in a minute, but firstly, just want to open it up and show you inside. So as I mentioned, there is two lids to these. Now they've got a foam seal, nice soft foam seal that runs around the edge of the lid here. A little chain here to stop the lid from going too far back, and that foam seal sits down inside this ridge here. So seals around the edge, each compartment is individual, so you've got this bar between both compartments here, so you can set both compartments at a different temperature and it seals it nice and firmly down inside there. In terms of the space inside the fridge, two compartments slightly different. This one's got a bit of a shelf in it, so talk about depth first. This depth here to the shelf, which is on top of the compressor, is about 16 centimeters, and total depth to the bottom of this compartment and the other compartment here is about 36 centimeters to this edge here. And you've got a little bit of extra height once you consider the space up inside the lid here as well, because that's recessed back up a little bit. Depth this way is about 38.8 or just under 39 centimeters in width or depth, however you want to look at that. And each compartment is 31.6 centimeters in width this way. This one here is split up slightly more. So this is 13.6 centimeters in width, this point here. And the divider in the middle, for those who are interested, is about 8 to 9 centimeters in thickness, this little bit here. Now, I will just show you how things fit inside here, but before I do that, I'll just pull these out. But you do get an instruction manual with your fridge. You also get a 12 volt cable, which has got that Anderson plug on the end there, and then a cigarette or merit plug on the end there too. And then you also get a 240 volt adapter, which goes from 240 volt to the Anderson plug there, so you can power it up through two different sources, 12 volt or three different sources, 12, 24 or 240 volt. I'm just going to stick some bottles inside to show you how easily all these fit inside here upright. So that's a champagne bottle. Snowy's cuvee fits nice and easily. regular wine bottle, that's just a Chardonnay bottle, it fits upright really easily, and your regular Coke bottle also fits pretty easily. And if you wanted to use this side, you probably traditionally use this as a freezer, but you can fit upright bottles in there as well. Now all of these baskets come out, so while that's full, you can just lift this basket out to clean inside the fridge if you like, and while that's out, we'll have a bit of a look inside this compartment here. So you've got the refrigeration unit around the side here. You've got a little, I think this must be the sensor back inside here to pick up the temperature inside the compartment. Bit of a ridge around the base there for the water to collect, and that goes to a little bung there so that you can, nice large size bung actually, so you can easily rinse the inside of the fridge out. Same sort of features on the other side here, except we've got two different baskets. So instead of an L-shaped basket, they've included two baskets. So you've got one that sits on top of the compressor shelf there, another one that goes right to the base there. And if we have a look inside here as well, we've got another one of those little sensors there, possibly a light. I know, so the light is on the end here. If we look up here, there is a light on this end here, and the same light features in the opposite compartment. And at the base of this one, we've got another bung here as well. So you can easily clean these out, and the water runs out the bottom of the fridge. Next thing I want to do is plug it in and show you how the light looks when it's on and how to use the control panel. Now it beeps when you plug it in. I haven't talked about cable length yet though. So the length of the cable from the Anderson plug to the transformer here is quite short, but you've got probably a good meter or so between that and the 240 volt or end of the 240 volt plug here. And the 12 volt cable is about 1.8 meters in length, so plenty of cable length to set it up inside your car. Now, as I mentioned, when you first plug it in, it does beep, and this goes back to the last setting that it was on. So this hasn't been turned on yet, so there's nothing happening. If you unplugged it while it was turned on, it will go back to the last setting you had it on, so it would stay on. So using this fridge is really easy, so I need to turn this on. So I hold down on the power button here, it powers up. This panel shows us the current temperature inside the units, but I want to show you before we go into how to use this, just have a look up inside here. We can see the two lights that we've got, one on each compartment here, so one at this end, one at the other end here. So we've got little LED lights that light up inside the fridge here. Now they don't turn off as you close this. I can just see, you probably can't see it on the camera, but as I close that, I can see the lights remain on, but LED being such low draw, it really doesn't matter if that stays on while the fridge is closed. We're going to latch that down because I want to come back to the control panel here and show you how this works. Now, this is really simple to use, this fridge here. So this is telling us that the fridge is on at the moment. It's operating just fine. There are error codes that can come up if there is an issue. The user manual tells you what they are. But another thing to check if you don't get any power or nothing is happening when you turn it on here is check the circuit breaker on the end here. If this has popped out, just push it back in. That's just a safety mechanism on the fridge to make sure nothing goes wrong. There's a lot of parts you can replace on this as well. Just contact Evakool and they can arrange spare parts for you. So moving into how this operates, we turned it on, that's just the on and off button. To change the settings, we use this button here. So one press allows us to change the set temperature of the left-hand compartment. So I'm going to set that at minus 18 degrees. When it stops flashing, that then goes back to the actual temperature inside the compartment, so it's 17 degrees at the moment, and it's now cooling down. Two presses allows us to change the temperature of the right-hand compartment. So I might make that say 5 degrees, let that stop flashing. We've now got this set at minus 18 on this side, 17 degrees currently. We've got this one at 5 degrees on this side, 15 degrees currently. So it's cooling down as we speak at the moment. Three presses allows us to change between max and eco mode with these up and down buttons here. Use max mode in temperatures of sort of 30 degrees and above, eco mode in 30 degrees and below is what Evakool recommends. Eco just uses slightly less battery power, but it may not keep the fridge as cold if it is really hot outside. And lastly, four presses changes to the battery protection mode. So that's on low. We've also got high and medium sitting there, so you can just see the L, M, and H there. So it means the fridge will cut out at a different point or different voltage that your battery is at. So it's a battery protection system, and all those voltages are outlined in your user manual here. So probably best keeping it on low for the most part, but just do whatever best suits your setup. That is all the features of the Evakool Down Under 75 litre dual zone fridge freezer, made right here in Australia and signed by the maker. So a really unique Australian made product by an Australian company made for Australian conditions. You can check them out online at snowys.com.au where you find them at our lowest prices every day. If you do have any questions though, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest and greatest info, or check out some other cool fridges like these ones down here.